Octavia was a mare of exquisite tastes. She was a mare of class. A pony of delicate palates with an attraction to only the finest of the fine. Be it physical or musical, Octavia was one who cherished beauty in and of itself and held it with high regards. She considered herself fortunate enough to even set eyes on the sunny sight, and it made her heart throb the longer she gazed at the gorgeous construction. In other words, the cardboard box.
Are you okay?
Derby asked the stout musician, tilting her head a little with worry.
You're looking at me kind of funny.
Yes, yes. Octavia brushed a lock of mane from her face hurriedly, snatching the box from her outstretched hooves.
Thank you for delivery and all that. Nice of a pleasant day.
Derby jumped when the door shut to the back. She stood in confused silence for a moment. Octavia slid down towards the door with her back pressed centrally against the door, and she ran the tip of her hoof over the large, flat end of the cardboard box. She bit her lower lip and winked at the box. Tiny grin tugging at her as her fedlock rubbed against the naked skin.
Oh, I've waited so long for some pony of such magnificence.
He gave a sultry sigh, licking the slightly fragile end of the box.
Such simplistic loveliness, such marvellous and heavenly design. All your sides are so smooth, your ridge is so hard.
Octavia allowed herself an excited giggle, trying to open the knowledge and double down the sensory sculptures. Parsons of from her instruments dropped to the floor afterwards, but she hardly noticed. Entranced as she was by the hypnotically sexy power of the box.
Box!
Octavia cried passionately, slipping her lips into it and resting them against the
door. Oh, Box, I need you now.
She slithered a little further into the box, moaning pleasurably as her belly slid into her ribs, slipping further into the rest until the hard, rigid edge of the cardboard box covered. Ready to complain to the and a hot breath bounced back at her through the boundary of the box's
foot. Not so fast,
she gasped, nearly freezing.
Oh, Box, you're so rough.
Sick, the cardboard box seemed to reply, which was
a sexual mating.
Oh, yes. But Octavia should be able to be thrown back by the sheer erotic aura of her beloved box.
Oh yes, that's so good.
See, Zelita.
See,
Octavia sighed with a pleased grin, leaning hard against her boxing comrade again.
Come now, Box, thrust your solid stuff into my happy hole, and we will make marvellous melodies.
Octavia stopped suddenly, horrified. Her box was empty for gorgeous, without a doubt.
Fear not, mi amore.
The box seemed to speak to her as he changed his accent for no reason.
For my gorgeous are really rough. Oh, Boxy.
Octavia rose beside the box, deep spread into the next
Your unbelievably stimulating rolling are getting so wet. Say something else. Say something else. Really ramming your rocket, my rosy ridge really riles my rock hard. Out celestial, yes!
Octavia walked out of the park, clenching the cardboard box's ear to her lips, as another rippling wave of pure ecstasy escaped from her lips. She slid down on the edge of the tree, ruling a little over the edge. She huffed with desire and heat, slowly fighting herself against the box, wet and slapping her sweet. Wiped so aside. It was then that someone something that should have something.
Boxing.
Octavia froze, checking between her You're going soft. It is true. My time has almost come. You can't die now! She sobbed hysterically. Oh, boxxy, my life is meaningless without your cardboard stiffy. How can I ever live without you? You must go on, my love. The boxxy insisted, lovingly touching her lips to his cardboard kiss. There are plenty of other boxes in the sea. But I don't want another box! Octavia cried, pushing her second stiffy. And gradually looking inside once more. You're the only box for me, box. You're the only non-stallion I want to pump my pig. I have not much time left. Her cardboard lover was constricted into her ear. If I am to go out to sea, then let us consummate our love in a box of life and passionate glory. Yes, I'll marry you. I'll take your pleasure myself. Celestia, yes, box, it feels so good. See. Octavia wrote her box long and hard. Each orgasm lasted longer than the previous one. She must have climaxed another 5 times before the card was finally sent, and her box overstirred the answer to the moon. Octavia finally relaxed her hand on her head and pieces. Head fuzzily danced. Her bleary smile was accentuated with a wet smack on her lips when she tasted herself, licking her lips from whether to find her satisfying as she spread herself freely in front of her face. She promised to keep the boss in her memory forever, for he had sacrificed himself for her multiple orgasms. Surely the best way to go. Final scratch almost dropped the bags of groceries and came across the walking male man standing just outside her window, her mouth hanging wide open.
What are you doing?
Final furrowed her brows, and Derby only lifted a shaky hoof to point at the living room.
Watching the show.
What show?
Final nodded slowly and understanding. Her roommate still rubbing herself with her own crying through the window. The shades clearly filled with light over. Bits of cardboard. Scraps of cardboard. All over the place. Do you know what this means?
Derby breathed in awe, staring at her own lips.
Does this mean that I have magical delivery sex powers?
No.
Finally, head panicked. Sorry. It means Octavia mixed up her anxiety pills with my ecstasy again.